Welcome to lecture number 27 of the series Unreal Engine 5.1 for Archviz, and in this lecture we'll create a custom material for the glass of these windows. Okay, so let's get started. One thing that I did off camera was to remove the Solidify modifier from all of these windows so that I don't have any sort of depth or thickness on my static meshes. Okay, and you'll notice one more thing, that if you remove the Solidify modifier and you go into the face orientation mode, you'll see that you'll have bad normals on this side of the mesh. Okay, which is totally normal because we have removed the Solidify modifier and any sort of depth and thickness on our static mesh. Okay, for now we're not going to worry about these, because once we are in Unreal Engine, we'll create a two-sided material and it will cover both of the sides of our static mesh. Okay, yes, so let's jump back in Unreal Engine. Here we are in Unreal Engine, so let's create a material for our glass windows. Okay, I'll go into my materials folder and let's create a new material. I'll rename this one as windows underscore glass. Okay, I'll open this folder and let's create a material. I'll rename this one as glass. I'll open this material. Okay, let's tweak some settings. I'll change my blend mode to translucent because this is going to be a translucent material. Okay, and I'll check this box, two-sided. Okay, because this is a two-sided material. Let's scroll down and I'll change my lightning mode to surface forward shading. Okay, yes, let's add a base color node. I'll add metallic node as well, and let's add a specular node. We're gonna need a roughness node as well. Add opacity node. Okay, yes, let's add a linear interpolation node. Okay, or what you can also do is press and hold L on your keyboard and press left mouse button and it will bring in a lerp node or linear interpolation node. Okay, yes, let's add a constant. I'll connect this constant with A. I'll add another constant and let's connect this constant with B. And I'll add a Fresnel node. Okay, let's connect this node with alpha. Yes, let's increase this to 1 and let's convert this one to parameter. I'll rename this as IOR, or index of refraction. Okay, and I'll connect this node with my refraction. Okay, let's apply this. And I'll create a material instance. And I'll apply this material instance on my windows. Yes, okay. Let's open this material instance. I'll check all of these boxes. And for index of refraction, let's type in 1. For metallic, I'll type in 0.1. And I think the opacity of 0.5 or 0.4 will be okay. Let's try 0.5 for now. Roughness can either be completely 0, or you can type in 0.1 or 0.01 will be fine. Yes, let's try specular of 0.4. Let's increase this to 0.5. Okay, yes. Yeah, okay. And let's apply this material instance on all of the windows. Okay, yes. Now you should know one thing, that this material is not for path tracing. Okay, this material that we made is for Lumen. If you want to render your scene in path tracing, for that we'll create another material. Okay, so let's create a new folder and I'll rename this folder as windows underscore glass underscore path tracing. Okay, and I'll rename this folder as windows_glass_lumen. Let's open this folder and I'll create a new material. And I'll rename this material as glass_path_tracing. Okay, I'll open this material. And let's tweak some settings. I'll change my blend mode to translucent and make this a two-sided material. Okay, and let's scroll down and I'll change my lightning mode to surface forward shading. Okay, yes. Let's add base color node and metallic node and specular node. Let's add roughness node as well. Okay, and let's add an opacity node and let's add a refraction node. Okay, yes, I'll rename this as index of refraction, or you can keep it as it is. Okay, let's apply this material and let's create a material instance. Okay, let's apply this material instance on these windows. Yes, let's open this material instance. I'll check all of these boxes. Okay, let's increase the index of refraction to 1 and I'll increase my metallic value to 1 as well. Let's type in 0.2 for opacity. I'll keep my roughness at 0 and let's increase specular to 1. Yes. And let's change the base color of our material. Yes, I'll press OK and I'll cancel it. Now to view this in path tracing, I'll select this view mode option, select path tracing. And it will take some time to render the scene. Let me hide my curtains, okay, and let's have another look. I'll go into post process volume and let's type in path tracing. Okay, and let me increase this to 512. And also I'll increase my exposure. Okay, so this is how our glass will look in path tracing. I highly recommend you to use path tracing because path tracing gives very photorealistic renders, especially when it comes to translucent materials. Okay, it may not look very photorealistic right now, but once we'll do some lightning and add some foliage in our scene, it will look a lot better. Okay, so that's it for this lecture. In the next lecture, we'll apply materials to our exterior walls and rest of our exterior static meshes. Okay, so I'll see you guys in the next one.